So obviously one thing you have to be very careful about when you're putting a turbine engine in the back of a composite helicopter is fire. So over the course of the last few weeks, we've been conducting some tests on some of the candidate materials that we were looking at for the firewall that sits in the back of the engine bay on the back of the aircraft. This isn't a structural component, this is purely there as a box to contain all the fire hazard and keep it and its heat away from the sensitive composite structures. And these materials will be necessary both for the airframe, but also for the inside of the cowlings to make sure they maintain structural integrity. Let's go and have a look at the rig and I'll show you some of the samples that we've been testing. So there are three basic approaches that we've taken. This simple rig applies a flame directly to the surface at the prescribed distance away for the certification test. This isn't a calibrated test, this is just an engineering test for our qualification purposes. The three main approaches that we've taken are to use either a conventional stainless steel or titanium firewall, as you'd find in most traditional helicopters, and use that as an insulative barrier and a firebox. The downside with that is it's generally quite heavy, and in order to control production costs, you're limited to very truncated shapes. So it would make the firewall quite large and have an impact on the shape of the fuselage if we use the traditional method. But we've done that as a control specimen. The next approach is to take a normal piece of composite material and then apply to it a flame retardant coating. And again, remember, this isn't a structural part of the helicopter. This is a separate molding that sits in there, but is coated with this material to enable it to withstand the flame for the required period for certification. We've shown that these methods work incredibly well, far better than you'd expect. They're not at the level of a traditional metal firewall, but they meet the requirements by far. And then an alternative approach that we've got is essentially to create the firewall with a very specific resin system where the resin itself is fire resistant to the extent that's necessary. So it maintains enough integrity that it just gradually pyrolyzes the resin and leaves you with the fiber. So it loses a lot of its mechanical strength, but for a non-structural panel, as long as it holds together for long enough, that's good enough. So we have a range of options here for both the firewall inside the engine bucket on the back of the fuselage and also the cowlings themselves. So we can just take our geometry and apply some of these material technologies for the final recipe for the firewall in HX50.